Hey, you two Pie Pals.
We have a Yabu.
We just got it in today from Man with a Plan, Harlow. We got his traveling tin of perfection. So, started with Cunningham 1977. He went to his tobacconist and they found a tin of perfection. Like 10 years old, I think. And he was kind enough to send it out into the YouTube pipe community for us all to try.
You can't tell if it's smoke or frost.
It's cold in here. It is very cold.
It's supposed to get down to the...
I need to go ahead and put up some insulation and finish the garage. I really do need to. Anyway, make it a real man cave. Need to build a fire in the man cave.
Fire and roast some meat.
Fire in the man cave, roast some meat. So, Rachel, my official Yabo opener, is going to open our package.
Some housekeeping first. I am smoking my Savinelli Alligator. In it, I have some Sutliff Charlemagne. Which is pretty good. This is the first time I've smoked it. It has some interesting flavors that we're trying to figure out. Nathan said it tastes like eggnog. I was getting kind
eggnog
of
eggnog with nutmeg. Had some eggnog and nutmeg last night. On top last night, and we warmed it up and had some. And she is blowing the smoke on me now, and it smelled just like it.
Like it smells like eggnog.
Like it smells like eggnog.
To me, it has like a nutty taste. But then there's a hint of fruit, like a prune raisiny taste. So it's like nutty and pruney. Pruney raisiny nuts.
Eggnog.
Anyway, what are you smoking?
Smells interesting. I am smoking my Thompson Mirror, sent to me by Aaron, Briar Boy. And in it, I have some various Virginias.
Various Virginias.
Yeah.
At the end of tens.
Well, I rub them out, let them dry a little bit before I pack them, and whatever's left, I put in a little tin, so scraps. But it's all Virginia, so I mean, there's a little Stonehaven, some chocolate flakes, some luxury navy flakes, some bullseye. I mean, there's a bunch of
various Virginias.
Various Virginias. It's very tasty though. It's very yum. It's very yum to
it's
me.
It's not life approved.
It's good.
This one makes a lot of smoke.
How's that not burning your tongue right now?
All right, let me open this package.
All right, there we go.
Here, you keep my pipe lit. Be the pipe walrus.
Thank you.
Walrus. Be the pipe walrus. Pipe walrus.
It tastes like nutmeg. It tastes like nutmeg.
Really?
Yeah.
Special Yabo knife. Pretty much only used for anyway. Yabo. Off to the package.
Corner of the trunk, and I opened up. You sent some extra stuff.
So to the package, I have just a little note. Says Nate the Great and Turneroy 8. How's the weather down there?
That rhymes. I never noticed that before. Nate the Great and Turneroy 8.
How's the weather down there? Around 50 here. Well, here's the 10-year-old tin of perfection. This traveling tin was started by the Cunningham 1977. See my video for the list of everyone else that's tried it. I threw in a few samples as well. I hope you enjoy them. You've probably already had most of them. There's also a couple wife-approved blends for the turtle. take care, guys, and keep the smoke a rolling. Aaron, Man with Plan Harlow. That's fun.
Thanks, Aaron.
So let's see what we got in here.
Here's the list of names. So it started from the Cunningham 1977, and then it went to Angela and Eric, Eric's Running World and Angela's Brandy Bag. Then it went to
Flag 1122,
and then to the Black Pearl King, Stogie Farts, then Brock's Daddy, then None Your Damn Business, and then it went to
Man with Plan Harlow.
Man with Plan Harlow.
And then us.
So,
So let's see what's in here. So first, there is the Traveling 10 of Perfection. Wow, that's fun. So what is Perfection?
I think it's an English blend. They don't make it anymore. I don't know.
Here's the 10. Let me take a whiff of this stuff. Oh, it's definitely an English. Oh, smells like shoe polish and a half.
Mm, that smells good. Let me smell. Let me get a good whiff of that.
So the Traveling Ten of Perfection is obviously not wife approved. I can tell you from right now, without Nathan even smoking it, that it would be not wife approved.
So it's a ribbon cut. It's nice and dark. I don't know if you can see that. Really dark tobacco. It has a nice Latakia smell. I'm sure the Latakia is mellowed out after
it
the years.
It smells very much
so it's
like
probably a really smooth blend.
Smoky.
I'm going to wait to smoke this and smoke it with my dad.
Oh, yeah. We'll probably go next weekend.
And so we'll do a little video from up there. It smells really good. So we'll do a little video with my dad. We'll smoke some 10-year-old Perfection. See if it lives up to its name.
And we'll get back with you guys on that. Oh, what else is in this package? We've got some Cornell and Deal Black Duck, which smells like a light English after smelling that Perfection. It doesn't have...
Oh, it's not, like a broken flake.
Yeah, it's not super strong.
Oh, that smells good.
Kind of a light.
That smells good. Smells like something I'd like.
This one is Maris Schwab's Lexington, Kentucky.
Hmm. It's not snuff.
You should not stick your nose all the way in the tobacco.
It's a coarse snuff.
This one smells like potentially an aromatic. Has that kind of raisiny smell. Not really a...
So I think it's a...
Or, yeah, it's not in English.
Like a Virginia?
Something, yeah.
Well, there's some, probably some Cavendish and some bright...
Oh, wait.
Some bright yellows.
The name is Maris, and the thing is Schwab's in Lexington,
okay,
Kentucky.
In Lexington. So it's their,
It's
their
house
blend, probably.
Like a 1Q or something.
That's definitely a 1Q.
Not 1Q-ish.
No, because it has the black Cavendish in there, and it has some bright yellows and maybe some...
Yeah, it smells good. We'll try that. I'll try that out for you guys.
Some reds.
All right. So the
some
next...
Burleys.
The next one is Paul's Stuff from Schwab's Pipes and Stuff in Lexington, Kentucky. So from the same place.
Must be your local B&M.
Yeah.
Is he from Kentucky?
Please. Lexington, Kentucky.
Okay, so it's I thought it was Tennessee. It's from Tennessee.
It says Kentucky.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
That has an Englishy smell. Oh, here's what... This one says wife approved on the bag. That's funny.
That smells really light and sweet, too.
This one is Dark Rum, also from Schwab's. Ooh. What you're smoking smells disgusting. This smells kind of like Barbados Plantation. If you guys have smelled Sutliff's Barbados Plantation, it has that same kind of really dark rum smell. Yum. Yum. I'll probably like that a lot. Oh, and this is Molto Dolce! The first ever wife-approved tobacco. It always smells delicious.
And from what Sutliff is saying, it's, I think they're number one seller.
Because it's a nice aromatic. It doesn't have a really heavy taste, so people who don't like aromatics because it's a heavy taste, Molto Dolce is a good... It's a sweet blend. The smell is sweet, so you don't offend anybody around you. And it's not super... like, it doesn't have a super taste to it, so... Anyway. Ooh! GLP's is Gaslight.
Ooh, thanks, man. I've been actually really wanting to try that, so I'm excited. Thanks. Thanks, Aaron. That's a...
Ooh, that one's definitely not wiper proof.
That's really cool. Looks like a...
It smells like Jackknife Plug.
A pressed...
Oh, no!
A pressed cake?
Yeah.
That's really cool. Oh, that smells good to you. Thanks, man. I really did want to try that.
All right, so I'm going to tell you what, Man with Plan Harlow. This is what you have managed to do in this package, which is not an easy feat. You've managed to send the most wife-approved tobacco, which is Molto Dolce, and the worst wife-not-approved tobacco, which is Pirate Cake. Best.
I'm surprised everything doesn't smell like Pirate Cake.
How did you manage this? Because this is the standard to which all not wife-approved tobaccos are held to. They're either as bad as Pirate Cake or just not wife approved. Pirate Cake is horrible. It is the worst tobacco ever, ever, ever. And Nathan loves it. And he stinks like stinky stink stink whenever he smokes it. So good job, Man with Plan Harlow. You hit both ends of the spectrum in one package.
Props.
Good job.
Thanks, Aaron.
Yeah, thank you. That's lots of fun goodies in your bag.
I will send you a little Christmas baggie too. Some little Christmas yabo, probably yapo.
I'm freezing.
It's cold in here. So, thanks. We will smoke the perfection, my dad and I, and give a little review on it.
And I'll be sure to tell you in the background how not wife approved it is.
We will send it along to the next lucky piper, and. There's plenty of baccy left in there. I mean, it's still... I mean, it's...
Yeah, one bowl is... It's good. That's lots of fun.
If it's really good, I may smoke two bowls. But,
probably not, because it's stinky.
That means it's extra good. So... Thanks.
Yep, thank you again. Thanks to everybody who kept the chain going. I know,
So that's one... Well, if you count Angela and Eric, that's one, two, but we'll count them as one. So that's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
And then eight to us. Why? We're eight. Number eight, too? That's even better. We're the eighth delivery of this package, which makes it extra perfect. Perfection.
No, 13 would be perfect.
Anyway. So that's lots of fun. It's interesting to do things like this in the pipe community. It's really cool how, everybody sends it along, and we've all smoked from the same tin, one of those kind of things, which is lots of fun.
Yeah, I don't mind smoking from the same tin. Same pipe? Maybe not.
Maybe if we clean it.
Well,
I mean, you and I, that's different.
Puff and pass.
I already have your cooties. Ugh.
Puff, puff, give.
Did you lick all over your pipe?
I think you just did. Gross. There's like a... left a string of whatever.
No, it was already on there.
That's my saliva? Yes. That left a string on your lips?
Yes.
That's gross.
Can you... This is totally gross.
All right, well, anyway, we'll go.
Yeah, thanks again for sending the package out. We'll have lots of fun. We'll post a video when Nathan and his dad smoke it. And we'll let you know how... what we think about Schwab's tobaccos that he sent us.
In Lexington, Kentucky. All right. Bye, YouTube.
All right. Bye. Oh, pipe smoking's like mud wrestling. It's kind of nasty, but it's lots of fun.
Fair winds and following seas. Until we meet again.
Aloha.
Can't say aloha. That's a...
That's hello and goodbye.
Yeah, but that's Eric's.
Au revoir.